On the Sail Guru Show today, we've got three huge stories. Each is an absolute killer in its own category. I'm going to take you through each of them right now. First and foremost, the one thing that we all wait for year by year, sometimes there's a 1.5 year wait, sometimes 2 years wait. Corning Gorilla Glass changes generation. And do remember, it's one of the most important events in mobile phones because this is the one thing we touch. This is the one thing that is our display. This is the one thing that saves us when our phone actually slips out of our hand, when our phones are in our pocket, when they're in our bag getting scratched. Corning Gorilla Glass is the savior. They move on now to Corning Gorilla Glass Victus. Yes, they have a name this time, not a name generation where they actually just put a number in front of it. We'll talk to John Bain, the man behind it all, the man who runs Corning Gorilla Glass globally. Then we'll move on to the other big, huge story. This is the OnePlus Nord. Finally, OnePlus doing something that they had never ever done before. Reaching a category, actually putting their hand deep into a category they'd never played for before. A mid-priced OnePlus phone. It's turned out to be a fantastic one. Then we'll move on to this. It's a dual review. The Redmi Note 9 in itself, a very important phone, but even more importantly, the choice of their processor, the MediaTek G85, is actually a masterstroke because this processor has pretty much got it all. And that also makes this an incredible phone that is able to do things in performance, in optics, everything else that very few phones can actually touch. I told you right in the beginning, huge show today. Don't go anywhere. Your next 30 minutes is with me right here. And let's move on now to news coming in from the world of mobiles. And of course, the biggest piece of news that came in this week is the new ASUS ROG 3. ASUS really set up what gaming phones should be all about. And every time the next generation of phones comes in, it does something dramatically different. Well, this time, the 3 is absolutely incredible.
If you take PUBG seriously, you will love the latest gaming phone from ASUS.
Ladies and gentlemen, meet the ROG Phone 3.
The company launched the ROG 3 this week, and it packs cutting-edge specs like a Snapdragon 865 Plus processor and offers up to 16 GB of RAM, though in India you will only be able to get it with as much as 12 GB of RAM and 256 GB of storage. It comes with a 6.59-inch display with a 144Hz refresh rate, which should allow for the smoothest possible gaming experience. The ROG 3 has a RGB logo at the back that can fully be customized, and the phone has two USB ports so that you can play and charge at the same time. It is priced starting at 49,999 rupees, and we will review the ROG 3 next week on Sell Guru. Samsung has announced an upgraded version of the compact foldable Z Flip. The updated model packs the latest Snapdragon 865 Plus processor and has 5G capabilities. Also this week, we got some leaks and rumors about Samsung's other foldable, the Galaxy Fold. Leaks suggest that the Galaxy Fold 2 will have a larger screen between 7.7 and 8 inches compared to the 7.3 inch screen on the original. Samsung is expected to launch the Galaxy Fold 2, but with Samsung's Unpacked event coming up on 5th August.
Our top story today is Corning Gorilla Glass Victus. Yes, from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to 6, they always had a name that actually was followed by a number. This time they've gone with a name and named the glass, which I think is fantastic because Corning Gorilla Glass that has so much of innovation and technology, so much that they've done in terms of what they've taken it to the next generation, I think a name is absolutely appropriate. So what did Corning Gorilla Glass do with Victus? Victus means to live, as in we spend our lives with our phone, we have to live with them, and those phones should be absolutely dependable and durable. So what did they do? Normally they go after one thing, either the drop test, which is how will it survive if it actually drops from your hand, or they go with the scratch part of it, as in how durable is the phone, how anti-scratch resistant is it, or they go with the economics of things, how much will it cost for a company to actually go with Corning Gorilla Glass versus a generic piece of glass. This time they hit all three targets.
Think about these two things before we start on this story. First, how many times in a day do you touch glass? Anything you estimate would be wrong. We touch glass thousands of times a day, as literally all our touch screens on our phones, tablets, and now even laptops are all glass. And chances are that almost all the times we touch glass, it's Corning Gorilla Glass. Now for thought number two, when you accidentally drop your phone, or it gets swiped off a table and falls down, or it's in your pocket along with keys, or your handbag with coins, how does your phone survive all these sustained pieces of torture? It's mainly Corning Gorilla Glass that does its magic. That's why when the next generation of Corning Gorilla Glass is announced, it's a very, very big deal. Because with every generation, Gorilla Glass has become tougher and more durable. While Gorilla Glass 3 was designed to help reduce scratches on your phone's display, with Gorilla Glass 4, 5 and 6, the company focused on making sure the phone survived drops. But what if there was a better solution that tackled both problems? Yes, we're talking about Corning Gorilla Glass Victus. This is the latest innovation from the company that focuses on both scratch and drop protection for smartphones, tablets and any accessory like smartwatches that use glass. Corning Gorilla Glass Victus, the flagship product from the company, can help a phone survive a drop from as high as 2 meters, which is a 25% improvement over Gorilla Glass 6, and is twice as much as that of the closest competitor. But that's not all, Victus is also twice as strong as Gorilla Glass 6 when it comes to scratch protection. The company uses a Noop diamond test to see how much force is needed to create a visible scratch in the glass. And Victus can take an incredible lot. Could it finally be the end of using screen protectors and cases on your phone? Well, with the third part of this wheel also in place, which is pricing, it seems like we can all afford the protection that Gorilla Glass can give us. Yes, Victus has kept the price point the same as the previous generation, while taking a quantum leap forward in glass technology. Time to find out more directly from Corning.
And now let's have a chat with John Bean from Corning Gorilla Glass. He heads the entire company, he runs this, and he's very passionate about what he does. Okay, first let's start off with the entire idea. I love the idea that you've given it a name, Corning Gorilla Glass Victus. But how did you take the decision? There must have been millions of other names also that you must have thought about.
And yes, we could have done the sequential numbering. It would have been an easy decision, but we don't think that would have sent the appropriate message, which is how special this glass is. Our prior generations kept improving drop because that was the number one concern of consumers. 2 years ago, we started working on this glass right after we launched Gorilla Glass 6. And as we developed it, we went out and surveyed consumers and said, what's most important to you in a phone? And number one was brand, no surprise. Number two, which did surprise us, was durability. It scored higher than screen size and battery life and camera quality. So durability is critical to the consumer. And we said, well, what do you mean by durability? Do you want better drop or better scratch? They said both. And we had never attacked both at the same time. Our last three generations were all focused on drop. So we challenged our scientists and technologists, and they actually delivered a glass over this two-year period. And that's the point we realized we had something really special. And maybe we should consider coming off the numerical convention of naming Gorilla Glass and find a name that really evoked the power of this product.
This time you've done something very remarkable. You've actually gone after three major targets, right? The drop test part of it, when we actually have our phone slip out of our hand or it falls off a table. The anti-scratch resistant part, how scratch resistant is it? That's the other part that is very, very important. And the economics of it, that also is a very, very important thing.
Well, the science of glass is very complicated. We don't need to go into the details, but if you're trying to optimize something for drop or scratch, you can start with the composition, but then how you process the glass. And sometimes to make it better for drop, you have to sacrifice on scratch and vice versa. So the real hurdle we had to get over was improving both at the same time. And we actually did that with Victus. We now can drop Victus in our test vehicle on a face drop rough surface at 2 meters, which is 25% higher than our previous best-in-class glass, Gorilla Glass 6, but over 2x the competitive glasses. And then for scratch, what we do is we take a diamond indenter and drag it across the surface and slowly increase the force until a scratch appears. And versus Gorilla Glass 6, Victus takes 2 times the amount of force, and versus competitive glasses, 4 times the amount of force. So those were stunning results. And then the third element we don't talk about as much, but probably equally important, is when you process the glass that scratches better through the supply chain, you get higher yields. So now when our customers turn our glass into a part, even though the glass costs a little bit more, it yields higher and the manufacturing cost is lower. So net net, the part costs about the same as Gorilla Glass 6. So now we've given 2 meter drop, 2 times better for scratch at about the same part price. So that's really the value proposition, which is super simple, super clean, super compelling.
So John, a very important question that comes from the economics part of it. So if Victus is going to be the same as Corning Gorilla Glass 6, that basically means that all the previous generations of Corning Gorilla Glass will become that much more effective in price, right? Will we be able to see more companies, more brands take to Corning Gorilla Glass?
It really comes down to the economics. So if people simply can't afford another 30 or 40 rupees to get that phenomenal protection for whatever reason, because the price point is just too low for the phone, they still need other glasses they can choose from, which is why we still have Gorilla Glass 3 in our portfolio, which is our most economic, cost-effective glass. We have Gorilla Glass 5 in our portfolio and Gorilla Glass 6. If I had to guess, I think Victus will start to take over the premium share, and then Gorilla Glass 5 will probably settle in at the intermediate, and Gorilla Glass 3 is still that option for people who are super cost-sensitive. But as we've talked about, Victus really plays across all the categories from entry-level phones all the way up to premium. And we know in India, 76% of the market is buying phones roughly 14,000 rupees or less. A lot of people are still getting their first smartphones, transitioning from feature phones. And we want that market, the significant part of the Indian market, to have the option to have the best glass available on their device.
We're moving on now to OnePlus Nord. And look, I have only one thing to say. It's a brand new space for OnePlus. If anybody thought of OnePlus, they always said, okay, one day I will strive to own a OnePlus phone. For Android market, they were the Apple of Android, the apple of everybody's eye. They priced themselves just about right, premium enough for people to think, I really aspire to own one. And the kind of features and specs that everybody said, wow. Now they've done something very interesting. The phone looks fantastic. I have to show you the phone. The phone looks absolutely fantastic. Now look, they've given us 3 covers with this, but this is a review unit. You may not get them. But the best part about the phone is how it actually looks. It's got as premium a look and finish as I think any OnePlus phone. Fantastic looking phone, fantastic screen, great optics on this phone, very good performance on this phone, great processor choice. So they've really done pretty much everything that you'd expect in a mid-priced flagship. Now you can actually buy a OnePlus even if you can't afford it.
From a flagship killer to making flagships, OnePlus made the stretch to the premium segment, but now it's flexing further into the territory of the 30,000 rupees segment by giving the much appreciated OnePlus experience. However, is the Nord capable enough to make the competition worry? And should it be your next phone if that's your budget? We tell you in our review. First, let's begin by telling you how much the Nord will cost you. The 6GB 64GB will sell at 24,999 rupees. The 8GB and 128GB variant is priced at 27,999 rupees, and the price of the 12GB 256GB variant is 29,999 rupees. The OnePlus Nord is an attractive phone. It has a plastic frame sandwiched between Gorilla Glass on the front and rear. We got the blue marble variant in for the review, and the eye-catching color stands out in the hand. The phone is light and comfortable to hold. The rear has a strip of cameras on the left that host 4 different sensors, and a subtle OnePlus branding. There is an in-display fingerprint scanner as well, which is quick to unlock the phone. Elsewhere, there is face unlock on board, which we found to be fast and accurate every single time. With a 6.4-inch screen size, a full HD AMOLED panel, and a 90Hz refresh rate, the Nord's display is stunning to look at. The colors are bright and vivid, and watching content is fun on it, even though it doesn't have a curved display. The cuteness of the Nord belies its power. Yes, this phone may not have the absolute latest processor, but the Snapdragon 765G with 12GB RAM and 256GB storage left no room for complaints. The Android 10 with Oxygen OS 10.5 over it is neat with barely any bloatware, and the company promises 2 years of full Android updates as well as 3 years of security patches, which is fantastic. Coming to the optics, OnePlus has almost gone all out here with a quad rear camera setup and 2 front cameras. The rear is a combination of a 48-megapixel main camera, which is the same as the one on OnePlus 8, an 8-megapixel ultra-wide-angle camera, a 2-megapixel macro camera, and a 5-megapixel depth sensor. The shots have a good amount of details and color saturation levels are close to real life. There are a lot of effects to play around with an excellent bokeh mode. The front is a dual sensor camera with 32 megapixel and 8 megapixel lenses. The selfies come out looking vibrant but are soft on details. The other lens enables ultra-wide selfies, which is a good addition if you like capturing large groups of people. The OnePlus Nord ships with a 4,115 mAh battery and supports 30 watts fast charging using the bundled cable and power adapter in the box. The phone easily lasted us a complete day of use with charge left over still. Sure, there is no wireless charging support and IP rating for this device, but this is where the corners had to be cut to keep the price down. The verdict. For anyone who wanted to own a OnePlus phone but couldn't due to the price, the Nord is for you. It is smooth to use with a clean user interface, good cameras and a decent battery life, and the top-notch performance gets the job done with ease. We like that the Nord doesn't leave us wanting for more, and it brings the OnePlus experience with everything you need to a whole new price point. Competition, beware.
Let's take a quick break right now on the Cell Guru Show. When we come back, lots more. Let's move on now to this, the Redmi Note 9. I said it's an important phone, but what's even more important is the choice that they've gone with in terms of the processor. This has the MediaTek G85. This makes a phone, a smartphone, even smarter. What all does it have? From the AI to the performance to how the cameras work to the optics to everything that you want, including gaming. This chipset has it all. We'll give you a short review of the phone and then we'll take a look at all the performance things that the chips actually can do for you, the MediaTek G85.
Smartphones have revolutionized mobile gaming and the chipset at the heart of your new phone plays a critical role in that. This week, Xiaomi introduced its latest budget smartphone, the Redmi Note 9. The Redmi Note 9 is an affordable smartphone powered by MediaTek Helio G85 processor that is optimized for the best gaming performance at the price. Can the phone redefine performance and value? Let's find out. Starting off with the design, Xiaomi has kept the styling similar to the Redmi Note 9 Pro, and the phone looks rather elegant. The phone looks and feels great, and the aqua green color in particular is very eye-catching. At the back, along with a fingerprint scanner, is a very versatile camera setup that includes a 48-megapixel primary camera, 8-megapixel ultra-wide, 2-megapixel macro, and a separate 2-megapixel depth sensor. We found image quality to be perfectly good for the price. There's an ample amount of detail, and if you like nicely saturated images, the photos from the Redmi Note 9 will delight you. The wide-angle camera comes in very handy in case you want to capture a large group of people. Finally, Xiaomi has done a rather good job with edge detection, and the portrait mode takes convincing looking shots. The MediaTek Helio G85 chipset on the Redmi Note 9 includes specific enhancements for improving scene detection and portrait mode, and it's very evident in our sample shots. The images from the Redmi Note 9 are a cut above the competition. With support for MediaTek NeuroPilot, the chipset is designed to offer the best possible AR and AI-based camera experiences. The selfie camera is housed in a cutout and has a 13-megapixel sensor. The front of the phone, meanwhile, has a 6.53-inch Full HD screen with Gorilla Glass 5. The screen is a bit reflective but goes bright enough to be easily viewable outdoors for those with long gaming sessions. Talking about gaming, let's switch over to the most important aspect of the phone. Yes, the Redmi Note 9 is powered by the Helio G85 chipset that combines an octa-core processor with a Mali G52 MC2 GPU. Now this is where things get interesting. As you know, the GPU is responsible for handling all graphics duties, and on the Helio G85, MediaTek has bumped it up to go as high as 1 GHz to ensure a stable and smooth frame rate. In fact, the chipset even includes a feature called the MediaTek Hyper Engine that dynamically manages all the resources from CPU, GPU to the RAM and even your Wi-Fi connection to ensure that your gaming experience is as good as it gets. Now, Xiaomi has added a large 5000 mAh battery to the Note 9, so you should easily get a full day of use. But the MediaTek Hyper Engine further fine-tunes all the facets of your smartphone to ensure you get a better battery life and all-day gaming. Additionally, thanks to the MediaTek Helio G85 chipset, the phone includes a low-power voice wake-up mode that lets you call up Alexa or Google Assistant using your voice while having minimal battery drain. The Redmi Note 9 starts at just 11,999 rupees for the 4GB RAM and 64GB storage variant. The top-end 6GB RAM 128GB variant is priced at 14,999 rupees, which is incredible value once you factor in the powerful MediaTek Helio G85 chipset, a quality camera, incredible battery life, and of course a great design.
That then is the Cell Guru show for this week, but do remember we've got lots of stuff coming up next week, including what made big news this week, the ASUS ROG 3.